Hello everybody, this is Adrian Bouchet here playing STEAPA. And it is now 6 o'clock in the morning and I'm leaving my hotel. Well, it's more of a sort of apartment block really, where we can self-cater for ourselves. And I'm about to get my ride into town. And this is Tom, who's our ride. Say hello, Tom. Now we're just on our way to go and pick up some of the other members of the cast from one of the swankier hotels. And some people are already there. They would have had call times probably at 5 o'clock or maybe even earlier. So 6 o'clock in the spring is an easy day and something to be thankful for. And this is our trailer park as I make my way to my little abode for the next 12 hours or so. Urkenwald, Edward. Compact and bijou. There's the weapons of choice. Stow my stuff. And this, oh, there it is. Ah, and here is the mail. It's not chainmail, folks, it's mail. That's what it's known as. Right, that's most of the undergarments of my costume on. And I will do the rest when I come back from makeup. Now, today I have lines, which, as regular viewers will know of the show, that's pretty unusual. And this is what the lines come on. They're called sides. It tells you all the scenes you're doing for the day, what times you're meant to be doing them. And my scenes are with Eliza, which is great because she's a sweetie, as you all know. Right, that's me out of makeup, looking suitably scarred and STEAPA-like. I just need the girls now to come in from costume and finish me off, so to speak. Today we are doing a wedding scene, and look at that. Yes.
It is going to get very hot in here.
So wave! It is now lunch. We have done just one scene this morning, which was successful, I believe. I stood at the back, as always, and I can tell you it's very tiring when you're 17 stone and 6'4". This is Ed.
Just got going to my trailer.
A new character this year. It's a shame that we're in the studio at the moment, well, for the day, because it is such a beautiful day, but we will reap the rewards next week when we're back out on the set. Now I'm going to go and have a lay down until they call me. And this is having a lay down. And we're into the final hour, and we're just about to do our scene. I am on blue, Eliza is on pink. And that is the end of that for the day. Daylight, and the end of another day. STEAPA got on, he stood around for a long time, we all know that, and he said some lines, so he's happy. And I think the director's happy, and that's a good thing because it's his first day and our first day on the last block. So, de-rig, transport home, and a beer. Now, I do have to say a little word about the facilities. This is what we've got. It's all fine and dandy. Sink, basin, toilet, shower, but not a lot of room to maneuver if you happen to have a long sword and all your armor on. So well worth planning your day beforehand, folks, so we don't have any unforeseen stopovers. Playing a role like STEAPA, it's obviously quite important to stay in some sort of shape, which is sometimes quite difficult when you're
working on a set for 12 hours a day, and in my case I could spend maybe 9 or 10 of those stood behind the king. You don't feel much like training when you get back. And my gym in my hotel accommodation is, well, it can't even call itself a gym. It's a treadmill and a couple of dumbbells. So when I first arrived in Budapest, I got one of the drivers to try and take me around to most of the gyms in, well, I think all of the gyms in Buda, and some of them in Pest. And actually, some of them were quite good. I eventually pumped for one which was about half an hour walk away, and I'd resigned myself to this trek every day and was on the first of these expeditions that I turned out of my hotel and prepared for this half an hour journey when I came across what you're about to see, which is my gym. It's, well, about 45 seconds away from the hotel. And it's like, it couldn't be easier. I am so lucky that I found it. It's one of the best gyms I've ever trained at. And I'm actually currently training with Arnold Schwarzenegger's stunt double for him, for his Terminator movie. Anyway, here we are. I'm going in. No gym selfies. Well, I got through that unscathed, so I'm pretty thankful. It's actually a very good gym, but the air conditioning is almost non-existent, so it's pretty sweaty. Anyway, I've got a 4:30 call tomorrow, so it's food, bed, and see you tomorrow. Oh my lord, today STEAPA has lucked out. Look at this puppy. Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh, now we're cooking. Oh, now this is having a lay down. Yeah. Furry walls. Cheers, everybody. Good morning. It is 4:15 and I'm in the hotel lobby waiting for my pickup. It's a very long scene today. It's about 9-10 pages. I think it's one of the longest scenes I've ever done. And I have lines. Most of the Saxons are in it, pretty much all the old cast and some new cast. And it's going on for about 2 days, it seems, so it's going to be quite a monster. And I had a good night's sleep, so I'm all set. And here's my ride.
Nice afternoon for a stroll.
All right.
We are on our way to do battle. Say hello, Tim.
All right.
Kev?
Hi.
Oh! Can you see it? Can you see it? War wound. That's where the axe got me. So here we are on a lovely, lovely Saturday afternoon in the woods rehearsing the battles and fight sequences for the culmination of the series. I've just done my little sequence. Will we finally get to see STEAPA show what he could do with a longsword? Well, we'll have to see. You've interrupted this broadcast. When we come back here on Monday, there are going to be hundreds representing thousands of warriors. And I'm very much looking forward to it. This is our out-of-town set. This is where Winchester and all the other towns that are featured in the show have their existence. And it's my last day today on this set. Any other scenes that I have will be on the in-town interiors. So this is it. Make the most of it. So I'm on a horse. And this is my stunt double, Norby. And I just want to show you this. How grey do you think I am? Really? And that is a wrap on me for today. Half an hour early, so that's good. Our mammoth scene is still not complete and they are still working on it, but not bad. I think it went pretty well. So, yeah, that's it. I can't tell you anymore because obviously it's all secret, but we got through it and I think everybody is happy so far. Linus!
What it is?
Enough of that now! That finally is the end of that scene after 2 days. We got to it, and I hope it'll be a very nice scene. However, with the end of that scene comes a slight tinge of sadness because some script revisions have come out, and it will mean that some people that thought they might be staying on to do extra episodes or seasons have been told that that is now no longer the case. Some others suspect that might be the case for them, and I myself don't know what my fate is yet, so I may be awaiting a letter or an email or a text or a visit when I get back to my trailer. But that is the nature of programs where a lot of people die, and you just have to accept that. But for now, lunch.
Sorry, I'm just...
Thanks.
Right.
This is it. Last day. 5 a.m. Big scene. Just about everybody's in. Not much sleep last night. But... let's do it.
There she is. So many people here. So many people. Oh God, fucking McIntyre again.
Mr. McIntyre has something to say.
It's the last day of Bouch. It's a tragedy, Bouch. There are so many things that have been unbouched, so many questions left unbouched, so many bouched that could have bouched, if only bouched.
We're going to have to cut short this transmission, sadly.
And that is a season wrap. on Mr. Bouchet. That's all, folks. Today I am going out, back out to the set, just when I thought I'd finished, to do some press stuff. So I'm the nominated one, and I'm heading back out there today. Right, that's it. This is my transport to the airport. It is currently 28 degrees in Budapest, and it is currently 5 degrees in London. And this is going to be a big wake-up call. The others are all on their way to the water park, and I'm on my way out of here for the last time.
Here.